chlorine reacts with various types of metals, and non-metals to produce their chlorides as products. So let us have some examples to explain which type of metals and non-metals reacts with chlorine to produce chlorides as ultimate final products. For example, aluminium can react with chlorine, so produces AlCl3. So 2 moles of aluminium by reacting with 3 moles of chlorine, it produces AlCl3, aluminium chloride. Similarly, iron can react with chlorine to produce ferric chloride. These two are the metals which reacts with chlorine gas to produce chlorides. Similarly, non-metals like phosphorus. Phosphorus can react with chlorine to produce 4PCl3. So phosphorus, by reacting with chlorine, it produces phosphorus trichloride as our compound. So this is the reactivity of chlorine with metals and non-metals. Similarly, chlorine will show high affinity towards hydrogen. Means, is there any availability of hydrogen in the given reactant molecules? It readily reacts with such hydrogen atoms to produce hydrogen chlorides. Here, high affinity towards hydrogen. So due to its high affinity towards hydrogen, it fairly or clearly reacts with hydrogen to produce HCl. So hydrogen, by reacting with chlorine, it produces HCl. Not only hydrogen, if there is any chemical substances present C6H10 or C6H14, it reacts with chlorine, produces 6 carbons plus 14 HCl. Hydrochloric acids are ultimate products here. So whenever the chemical substances having hydrogen atoms, those hydrogen atoms towards the high affinity by chlorine, so those reacts with chlorine gases to produce hydrochloric acid as our compound. So this is reactivity of chlorine with metals, non-metals, and reactivity of chlorine towards hydrogen. Similarly, so chlorine will reacts with cold and dilute sodium hydroxide to produce sodium chloride and sodium hypochlorite. NaCl and NaOCl are the products. We can write it as NaOH plus Cl2 gives rise to NaCl plus NaOCl plus H2O. So during the reaction, we have to use 2 moles of sodium hydroxide. So here, 2 moles of sodium hydroxide, cold and dilute sodium hydroxide By reacting with chlorine, it produces sodium chloride and sodium hypochlorite as our compounds. Similarly, the same one, chlorine will also react with hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide. Hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide to produce sodium chloride and sodium chlorate, NaClO3. So let us have the chemical reaction for this 6NaOH. So what is the condition of sodium hydroxide here? Hot and concentrated. So sodium hydroxide will react with chlorine to produce NaCl plus NaClO3. So these are the products released from hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide by reaction it with chlorine, and it produces water molecules. So this is the expected reaction which takes place with chlorine. Chlorine by reacting with cold and dilute sodium hydroxide can produce sodium chloride and sodium chlorate, hypochlorite as chlorite as products. Whereas when the same chlorine reacts with hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide, it yields us the formation of sodium chloride and sodium chlorate as the products.